I'm really sick, Ryan. I am at this point. Just 2 hours ago, we're talking to my uncle about the goddamn shooting at the University of Santa Barbara with that little punk-ass bitch who couldn't get laid, and the media had to make something of that. And I was thinking, okay, then we move on to a happier topic. We've talked about the Blackhawks and the Kings with my uncle. Then we talked about porn. We talked about a crazy teacher. And guess what,
yeah.
Ryan?
Porn is fun. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There's breaking news on WNUR. What's going on in SuperRICH News? I'm so sick to myself. I'm so angry. There's another shooting going on in Norfolk, Virginia. What the hell is wrong with you, America?
Oh, man.
Life is short. Appreciate the moment. Don't kill each other. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah,
put the gun down.
I don't like that.
I like being awake. I like waking up and saying I'm alive. Why are we killing each other? Why don't we use our talents and get famous a different way? These little punk-ass bitches who are killing each other, these Adam Landers of the world, these James Holmes, these guys that shouldn't even be saying their names to make their names household names.
Yeah.
How about you do something with your life? How about you get some medical help and not take it out on somebody else? And if you do feel like you have the need to kill someone, kill yourself, you scumbag leech bitch. So what's going on with this SuperRICH news in Norfolk, Virginia?
Well, this just broke, let's see, on your timeline, on your...
Just now.
Twitter, right? Yeah, just a few moments ago.
Yeah.
Shooting spree kills three, including officer and teen, on his way home from graduation.
So he just graduated high school, a milestone in his life. His parents are proud of him. Wow, time has gone by. He graduated. And then he dies.
And the photo of him, he looks like a very normal kid, right?
A very normal kid who had life going on towards him. Nothing was looking but up. Like, he just graduated.
Yeah, he looks like a good guy, but apparently
I wouldn't want to be friends with him. He just graduated, and then he dies. Go on.
Let's see. A 17-year-old was on his way home from a high school graduation celebration, and an officer and a police officer were among three people killed in a shooting spree in Norfolk, Virginia.
Yeah.
James Brown, 29 years old, is reported to have started shooting randomly Friday night as he drove through Norfolk. So we had the story a little screwed up as far as we originally thought that this was a 17-year-old that did the shooting. Right.
Well, yeah, because it was breaking. We just read it. Just getting on the air. We were going to talk about some other things, but then this came. So it's not exactly breaking, like it just didn't happen now, but it happened 2 days ago.
Right, and this is a 29-year-old James Brown who has reported to started shooting randomly Friday night as he drove through Norfolk. According to police, witnesses saw Brown shoot 17-year-old Mark Rodriguez.
But then, of course, this will be... swept under the rug by Wednesday. We'll go back to talking about that racist piece of dirt, Donald Sterling, because that's how the media is. We're so numb to these shootings, it doesn't even matter anymore. People are dying. Life is ending because these people keep shooting, and we're not covering it. We're making them celebrities. It's becoming more of a joke. Did you hear what Adam Lanza did now? Do you know what I mean? Like, we're just kind of becoming numb to it.
Yeah, and
what do you think?
Well, my take on it, every time there's a shooting, every time there's there's an Adam Lanza type thing or a James Holmes type thing, you know, there's other crazy people in the world, and they want to, you know, maybe be
get
the
same.
Yeah, they're like, oh, I could do better than that, or maybe like, oh, well, you know, this isn't so bad. My life's going nowhere. I'm not doing anything, so maybe I'll do this. It doesn't matter if I kill myself. I'm gonna hurt innocent people and do it because all these other people do it and they kill themselves.
Please.
And, you know, if you kill yourself, you don't have to face the consequences, right? So
you little pussy,
so
you little bitch,
might as well.
You coward.
I mean, if you're going to go through all the trouble, you might as well, you know, you might as well stand by your word and just stay alive and be in jail for the rest of your life.
Yeah. If you're so tough and you want to take other people's lives, how about you then face the consequence, but then no, you kill yourself? Or how about this? Just kill yourself and don't kill anybody else. What is this kid's name? What is his victim's name?
The victim or
the
shooter?
Yeah. We will just call him the shooter.
Yeah.
There's no reason out there to make his name a household name.
The victim was 17-year-old Mark Rodriguez.
So there is no reason for the shooter to take Mark Rodriguez's life. Because did the guy kill himself, the one that shot?
I don't know yet. I don't...
What else did it say? Let's scroll
Let's see. The teenager was on his way home at the time and was struck by at least one bullet.
That's horrible. You have that, like, glee of I just graduated high school, summer's out, I'm walking, and you get shot randomly. Like,
right.
God.
And he was declared dead at the scene. A police officer responding to the attack was also killed after he identified Brown's vehicle near his home. Brown shot officers Brian Jones and Curtis Allison multiple times from inside his home after they identified his car. Allison was injured as he attempted to aid Jones, who had been hit several times. Both officers were transported to a local hospital where Jones was declared dead. So, yes, he is dead.
So both the guy who was shot and the shooter is dead now?
No, the two officers were hurt, and one of them was declared dead. The other one Jones was declared dead. I think the other one's in critical condition. After injuring the two officers, Jones attempted to flee the area, but was stopped after crashing into another car. According to police, Brown refused to comply with another officer's commands and attempted to take the
officer's
car.
What a surprise. He didn't go with the cop's commands after killing somebody. Like, of course he's not going to. He's a scumbag bitch.
Jeez.
What? There's no jeez here.
No, I know. I know.
I know there's going to be someone out there tuned in. Oh, my God. He called someone a bitch. This is a murderer. I'll call him a bitch when I want. He's a bitch.
Yeah.
Scumbag. He's a dirtbag.
He's some other things, too,
that you can't say in the air.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, if this was SiriusXM, the Opie and the Anthony channel, I'd be laying it out. But you're a bitch. Right. You're a pussy. You're a coward. You're nothing but a scumbag. You're a failure. You're 29 years old. You did nothing with your life. So then you take away a life of a 17-year-old who had nothing but aspirations from graduating from high school. You're a leech, dude. You're a rodent.
So, Officer Brown was shot as he struggled with an officer who was attempting to arrest him. Brown was pronounced dead at the scene. So, yes, the shooter is dead.
Good.
That's official. After the shooting, Norfolk Police Chief Michael Goldsmith said Rodriguez has just been in the wrong place at the wrong time talking about the teen, and that losing an officer like Jones hurts. And Goldsmith and Jones was a 5-year veteran of the police force and is survived by his wife, two sons, and daughter, which sucks that they have to live with this. Officer Allison is expected to make a full recovery, so that's good news. That's about it about that.
Like, I'm not going to go on here and pretend like I'm some guy who's all up in politics right now, that I'm some guy that knows about the gun culture and that I know what the answer is. Because, frankly, there's not one person on this globe right now. There's not anybody in this universe that knows what needs to be done. But there needs to be, something needs to happen. And here's what I believe, Ryan. I truly believe this is part one of improving everything. Harvey Levin, HLN, Nancy Grace, Dr. Drew, CNN, Fox News, MSNBC, New York Post, anybody out there who makes this guy's name out there, please stop putting them on the front page of the cover. Harvey Levin called him the guy that shut up the movie theater in Colorado. They called him the Joker. There's no reason to give him that name. He was trying to be the Joker. Just refer to
him
as his name is James Holmes.
And you're giving him that fame that he wants.
Yes.
And, that's not a good thing.
And then you give the virgin killer who said in his YouTube video that he was a virgin killer. They called him that. And they had a screenshot of the YouTube video on the cover of the goddamn New York Post. What an embarrassment. What a joke of a publication you guys are. You're nothing but a little tabloid. You're nothing but a bunch of scumbags. And that lady from the Washington Post who's trying to say that the virgin killer should be blamed on by the movie The Neighbors because Dave Franco has sex in there. The media is ridiculous. The way they cover it.
Right.
Because these crazy people, they go, I want to be famous. I don't care about a person I'm about to kill because I'm crazy. I'm psychotic. I'll kill somebody. Then I'll be famous. No one ever appreciated me when I worked hard in school. I never played sports. I never was smart enough to go to a good college. I'm going to community college next year. What does it matter if I kill somebody, then I kill myself? I have nothing going for me, Ryan.
Right.
I'm just going to be in my mom's basement for the rest of my life, jaying off the porn. I have nothing going for me. So these guys then just go on these sprees because then they're named forever. Frankly, we know James Holmes. No one knew who he was in June 2012. And then comes July 2012, and he's a household name. I just want to give you a quick shout-out, Nancy Grace, HLN, any of these publications that are making them household names. Tweet at me if you want, at Hoppe Radio 893. Seriously, I'm not even kidding right now. Why are you making them household names? Do you agree with me? Why are you reporting it like that? Why is HLN having segments? Could this have been prevented? Did he need psychological help? Why are they focusing in on the killers? They're
right.
Scumbags. They don't deserve the attention. It's not even a joke anymore. Like, where the hell is the media going in 2014 when that's the front page coverage?
True.
When you have dramatic music in the background and you have hashtags Nancy Grace for killers. The Virgin Killer was actually a hashtag on her show. Baby Killer was a hashtag for the mom down in Florida. What's her name?
Casey Anthony.
She had some hashtags. Some show did. Zimmerman versus Trayvon. Like, get the hell out of here. You're profiting money, Ryan. These journalists go home to their huge mansions and their hot wives. Well, I mean, come on, Nancy Grace, you know her husband's a fat pig. I mean, look at her. But they go home, and they have nice lives. They don't have to worry about bills. They don't have to worry about someone dying. But what if this was Harvey Levin's boyfriend or Nancy Grace's kid, and we reported the killer as some celebrity? Oh, heaven forbid we did that. We'd be crucified. But when they do it for ratings, because they get money off the ratings of someone dying and hashtags, which gets them Twitter followers and newspapers that gets them money from the articles being bought and the newspapers being bought. Ryan, I've had enough, man. I'm at this breaking point. That is what needs to be done, part one. You need to prevent this. You need to quit making them celebrities. What do you think? What else could be done?
Well, making them celebrities doesn't prevent it, obviously.
And what else do you think maybe does it? Any other characteristics?
I mean,
a new epidemic.
It really is becoming an epidemic because now you'll see, you know, in a week or two, there's going to be another shooting of some sort with all this. And I don't really know the way to stop it. I just know that, you know, it keeps getting worse and worse.
It just seems
and
like it's
having
getting,
the media promote it as some sort of, you know, as like, as you said, as sort of like a thing that everybody likes.
As some sort of, like, entertainment or something to get ratings. What the hell, man?
Yeah, you know.
You bitch!
So, yeah, I mean, there's definitely different ways to go about it.
Anything else you think we could do? What about gun control? I don't know. It's not going to do anything.
Gun control?
The criminals are going to find ways to get guns. That's what I've always
said. Yeah,
I obviously
you shouldn't. I don't think you should have a ban on all guns, you know. Guns
that's
kill people like spoons make people fat. You know, you know, it's not. It's guns are getting into the hands of wrong people. You know, 40 years ago, we didn't have all these mass shootings. We didn't have people doing this,
or they just weren't reported on because like we didn't have social media too. That's the other thing.
Yeah, but still, there wasn't an epidemic like there is now in the last.
True.
I mean, even in the last 3 or 4 years, there's been more of an epidemic, I think, than we've ever seen. Like, you know, everyone says, you know, that it's not such a dangerous time, but it is.
Like,
this is a pretty dangerous era that we're living through right now, I think.
I was talking with some classmates at my school. Someone could just come in through the side of our door. One of our classmates was on crack and was crazy. He could have come in through the side door and shot us up.
And it wouldn't have surprised me in
the least.
There's
no security anywhere anymore. Like, you could just go into a grocery shop and shoot.
Like, my high school didn't have metal detectors, for instance, so somebody could have a gun in their backpack for the whole school year.
Our
and nobody
school
would
doesn't.
Know. Right,
you don't
right.
know? People just walk into our school. We've had friends of some of our classmates come and visit. How do we know that that might not be a friend and they're there to shoot
well,
up?
That's
we don't
sort
know.
Of the risk you take. But it's sort of like society and all these kids see that it's not such a bad thing. So you have to find a way to make people think that this is a bad thing and don't do it. You know, kill yourself, don't kill others.
I mean,
and even that sounds kind of bad. But honestly, if you're a crazy,
kill yourself,
effed up kid, you know, some 17-year-old, 18-year-old kid, just kill yourself. Don't kill others. Killing yourself, you know, sure, killing yourself will prevent you from killing other people.
Yeah.
And taking away all guns isn't the answer either. So, you know, all the completely left-wing people, all the completely right-wing people.
Get the hell out of you dumbasses. Get together.
They don't know what they're talking
get
about.
Get together.
You have to get together and come together with a compromise.
Get your act together, Obama.
Obviously, a compromise isn't to get rid of all guns. That's just silly.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, taking away completely everything from a certain thing isn't a good thing anyway, right?
Yeah.
Like, you know, taking away all knives, bad idea. Taking away all televisions.
Yeah.
The bad idea. that's not going to have kids go out and play more. That's going to make them mad because they don't have their TVs anymore, right?
Yeah.
So taking away all guns is ridiculous. But
what about
there's definitely a way to control it, and I don't know what that way is, but you have to find a way to control it.
You need to have background checks on people who buy guns.
That would make sense, and I know that people are doing things to try to make that more, you know, trying to make that happen more. But I don't really see a complete end to this, to this epidemic. But it sucks when you're in the wrong place at the wrong time.
I don't think this epidemic has began. I think we're in the beginning of the era. I don't think it's began.
Well, that's the problem too. I sort of agree with you there. Where let's just violence and everything, gun violence, and especially like all these mass shootings, like in Chicago and everything.
Right now, somebody died because of some dumb scumbag thug in Chicago. Like the violence never ends, Ryan.
Right, and you know it all started like in the late '80s, early '90s when you started to have all these shootings.
Columbine.
Then it started with school shootings, especially starting with Columbine and everything
else. I feel
like
that was the first one, but then for like 10 to 12 years, everyone said, okay, remember Columbine? But now it seems like there's so many, you would need like 12 Michael Murray documentaries.
Right.
You would have Bowling for Aurora, Colorado. Bowling for this, like how they had Bowling for Columbine.
Yeah.
My point is...
Well, that documentary is kind of stupid, too.
But... really is awful. There he is, banking money off of dead people. Good job, you fat
ass.
There
he is, Michael Moore, doing...
Michael Moore, not Murray.
Thinking taking away all guns is the answer.
You fat loser, go eat.
How is that the answer? Like honestly, like it doesn't even make any sense, really.
No, it doesn't.
Let's take away everyone's guns,
and then
what? Then everyone bombs each other. Like I don't know what happens next.
You grab knife. I could probably kill you with a fork if I stabbed you hard enough.
Oh yeah.
Come on. Take away everything. What are we gonna have? Like rubber. That's it.
Then take away everything. Turn into a communistic society, right?
Do we cut off our hands and our legs so we can't kick each other?
Should we be told when we go to the bathroom now?
Yeah, I mean,
honestly. I guess so.
All right. If you want to call in and give your opinion on this, 847-866-WNUR. It's 847-866-9687. All right. Here's a song dedicated to, what was his name? The guy that was shot. And everybody else that's been shot recently from these epidemics. But
his name was Mark Rodriguez, I think.
Mark Rodriguez, who just graduated from high school and got killed by the shooter.
I believe his name was Rodriguez.
Let's just make sure.
Yeah, I believe it was...
847-866-WNUR. 847-866-9687.
Yeah, his name was Mark Rodriguez.
Mark Rodriguez, rest in peace, my man. We hope you're in a better place. Up next is Songbird on WNUR 89.3 and the Hoppe and SuperRICH Show.